Good morning. My name is Mike. This is the Lenovo T440. Oh, and I review old laptops on YouTube. It's not exactly a hobby, but I do it because I tend to keep buying, for some reason, the same machine over and over and over again. And I like to remind myself of which machines I've had. Anyway, this, like I said, Lenovo T440, less than an inch thick. This is the i5 4th Gen. It's an i5 4300 processor. 1.9 gigahertz. This particular model is 8 gigs of RAM and a 128 gig SSD. It is super thin, super light. I love this machine. This is easily one of my favorite laptops of all time. The battery comes in a couple of different variations. One of them has a little bump on here, so it holds a bit more. But this guy should get you about 4 to 5 hours. And that is why I think that this laptop is probably one of the best laptops you can buy for students. It's right up there because the keyboard is awesome. It's thin, it's light, it's got a nice big 14-inch screen. What else do you really need as a student? Would an HDMI port be nice? Yeah, probably. This does not have that. Let's take a look at all the holes in the sides. Power, vent, display port, high-speed USB. Actually, I think that one might be powered because it has a little power thing beside it. Smart card reader, nothing on the front, nice and clean. Over here we have a headphone microphone jack, SD card reader, that's where a SIM card goes if you have a SIM card, high-speed USB, Ethernet port, VGA, who the hell uses VGA anymore, I do not know, and then, like I said, nice and clean design. Oh, such a beautiful machine. Now, one of my issues with this machine is if you're thinking of gaming, this is probably not the computer for you, because this is only a 1366 by 768 resolution screen. The screen, kind of crappy. The keyboard, though, beautiful. Might be a bit loud in a classroom setting, though. You might disturb a few of the people standing around you if you're taking notes. Big trackpad, but once again, this is the same trackpad that the X240 has. And it is, well, you can hear it, super loud. And the whole right side, I find, is kind of unresponsive. Like, if you're trying to right-click anything, it doesn't really work out that well. So I would suggest attaching a USB mouse. They're going to run out of USB ports pretty quickly. I love that matte finish. It's great for putting stickers on. And that's really all I have to say about it. It's a Lenovo. It's reliable. But let's dive into the stats on it. Okay, so for starters, let's do the one finger test. I don't think it's gonna pass. Nope. Okay, let's see how long it takes to start up. 3, 2, 1. Now I installed Windows 10 on this, and this basically shipped, I think, with Windows 8. It has a Windows 7 COA on it, but I shipped with Windows 10. And that was a pretty quick startup. Password is password. Let me just adjust this light. Now, do you see the lines going up there? That's because this is, once again, kind of a crappy screen. 1366 by 768. It's called an HD TN screen. It is not touch capacitive. I also have a ThinkPad T450S, which is a touch screen, which is a lot nicer screen, I might add, too. Right click. This mouse is horrible. Going into the system. Yeah, why is that taking so long? Yeah, not a touchscreen. Can you read that? i5 4300 CPU at 1.9 gigahertz, 2.49 gigahertz, 8 gigs of RAM, 64-bit OS, running Windows 10 Pro version 19.03. Now, like I said, this does have a 128 gig SSD in it. The video card is an HD Graphics 4400. The webcam is a 720p. It does come with Bluetooth, and this particular model has two batteries, like most of them in this series does, a 3-cell up front and a 3-cell in the back. So that gives you roughly, keep in mind it's not fully 100% charged, it shows 2 hours and 47 minutes remaining at 98%. Well, I know it's going to last more like 4 and a half hours, and you can get a much better battery for the back.
Now, these machines do run Linux also very well. This is just a plain Jane version of Windows 10 on there. Well, it's Windows 10 Pro, but still, this is for a friend of mine. Well, they needed a machine. I got this for a really good price. This is under $200 Canadian, which is probably $150 US. And now I know you're thinking that is kind of cheap, and you know what it is. It's a pretty good price. But if you're going to go out there and you're looking to buy a machine for a student, this is probably something I would seriously consider looking at. And Windows 10 runs really nice on here. The only thing with Windows 10, obviously, is if you need the Office applications, I would always suggest you try LibreOffice. Where'd my mouse go? See, look at that, I lost it. I'm playing with the mouse. Can't see, it's right here. I have no control. The trackpad is horrible. That's why, like I said, I always suggest getting an external mouse. See, it's just not responsive. See, the clickers work, but this part's not working. Okay, anyway, you should take a look at this, LibreOffice. It's a free version of Office, and it is really a great little application, in my opinion. You can save files for Excel and Word and everything else, and it's free, $0. Okay, that's all I really have to say on this machine. If you have any comments on it, leave them down below. I can crack it open if you want to take a look at the inside. I'll do that in another video. This is really just a straight overview of this hardware. And I do have a few machines I was thinking of that would be good for testing for students. This is another one. I reviewed his big brother the other day. I reviewed the Dell 7440. Well, this is the 7240. And it's a 12-inch version. i5 fourth gen as well. All right, that's all I have to say. If you like these kind of videos, leave a thumbs up. If not, leave a thumbs down. Hit that subscribe button right there. And leave some comments if you have any questions. That's it. Thanks for watching. Did I run out of color film? Why is it shooting in black and white? Is it because the laptop is black? Would this be different if the laptop was a different color, like red? I think there's something wrong with my camera.